Well done, fellas. First go as well.
Now the Herald's road legal, I can finally get a soul.
There's a massive show, classic car show, at the end of the week that I'd love to take this to. Loads of potential buyers. But to get top dollar for her, I need you to get it really, really clean, like mint
this
it
week.
Up this week. The enthusiasm is just overwhelming me.
This isn't your average Sunday morning once over. It's gonna need some serious grunt. The old-fashioned cellulose paint has been oxidizing since 1966, which is why it looks so milky. So we're using a mildly abrasive cream to remove all the dead finish on top of the paint. When she's back to the original signal red, she gets a good polish and a good waxing. A regular waxing will preserve a car's paint by stopping dirt and grime becoming bonded to the paint. A bit more of the car polish on the plastic back window cuts through years of grime, leaving it looking as good as new. If Paul can't sell this, he needs to find another job.
Fellas, that is absolutely beautiful. I can't believe how that's come up. You know what, I can almost see Dave's face in it, which isn't necessarily a good thing.
Looks right, doesn't it?
It does, it looks really, really good. Let's have a look at it. Oh, I'm so chuffed with that.
I doubt there's another Herald in this condition with this provenance outside of a museum.
Lads, I'm absolutely in love with this. You know, I said I don't want it over-restored. We just want to take what's there and make it as good as it can be. And I think we've done that. It's perfect. Absolutely perfect.
You see for what it is. There's nothing hidden.
I reckon the crowning glory's got to be that roof, though, hasn't it, really?
It looks like brand new, doesn't it? And this is the magic thing, that little Viaback stamping in the back. That's how you know it's an original roof. You can't recreate that. This is going to make top money. Well done, fellas. Shall we go? God, that runs well, doesn't it?
Nice, doesn't it?
When we got our Herald, she'd been sitting in a garage gathering dust for 14 years. In perfect nick, except for the cruel, inescapable deterioration that comes with age. This wasn't so much a restoration, but a revival. And we've given her back that 60s sparkle. You might see a better one, but you'll never see a more genuine Herald than this. She cost us £2,000 to buy, and we spent £1,500 on parts. Now I think she's worth every penny of £6,000, giving us a potential profit of £2,500. Dave's done his bit, so now I've got to sell her for the best possible price. So I've swung us a spot at the biggest standard Triumph event of the year, held at the home of British motorsport, Brooklyn. All the Triumph aficionados gathered in one spot to buy, sell, and just admire.
This place is immense.
There's everything from standards to stacks, along with the rarest of the rare, like this one-off prototype 2-litre six-cylinder Triumph Fury, which was designed by, you've guessed it, that sexy, glamorous Italian, Giovanni Michelotti, just like our little Herald.
Look at that, she looks good there. She needs someone to buy it. Open for a business. Can I interest you in this delightful Herald?
Are you impressed?
Yeah.
That hood is absolutely genuinely original.
Is it?
That's incredible.
The Triumph fans at this show love provenance. They love original features and they especially love all the history that goes with the car. Our Herald has that in spades. It's like it's been trapped in a time warp. At an event like this, the buyers are going to see all that and not be able to resist.
Actually, to be fair, I don't think I've ever seen one with a plastic on.
Well, there you go. So you need to see
that
the collection.
That is honestly
in 30 years.
It's not going to be an easy ride, though. These collectors are clinical. They know what every bit is worth, and they will scrap for every penny.
And I would like to get £6,000 for it, if I can.
That's a lot for a Herald.
Five and a half would be absolute tops.
There is no way I'm letting this go cheap. She's got everything. Great history, low mileage, and all the original features a buyer could want.
Have you seen the plastic on the inside?
Yeah.
That's honestly, that's how it came out of the factory.
And he's kept it like that?
Yeah.
The original logbook is in the glove compartment.
Wow. Yeah, seriously.
As well.
Buying a vintage car isn't a rational decision. It comes from the heart. Like Cupid, car salesmen have to get people to fall in love.
There you go. There you go.
Set the other side.
Don't force it.
I'm not forcing it. I'm being very gentle. That's better.
Oh, you see, that looks so natural, doesn't it?
Yeah, it looks absolutely brilliant in there.
Yeah, that's definitely a look for you, that.
To get top money, I've got to capture the imagination, get people to see how good life could be with this car.
Well, tell you what we could do, as we're at Brooklands and we've got one of the best hill climbs in the UK, why don't I take us all up the hill, and if you like the way it drives, you can buy it at the end.
Yeah, we can definitely talk about it, definitely.
A test drive is like a first date. You know in the first 5 seconds if you've fallen in love.
It's like Dave.
And there's no better place to fall for a car than Brooklands. This is the site of the world's first purpose-built racing track. And in 1909, they added a hill climb to test out their motors. Enthusiasts have been powering up Test Hill for over 100 years. Now it's our turn.
That's a steep old hill, that, isn't it? Here we go, guys. Come on, old girl. Come on. Oh, she's missing a little bit. She's a bit... You can do it.
Come on, please, come on. You're going to do it. You're going to do it. You're going to do it. You're going to do it.
Hey! That was fun, wasn't it?
It was. Amazing.
So the burning question after any test drive, would you like to buy it?
I would, yeah.
Well, come at me.
Well, I mean, I was looking to sort of top range to spend like 5.5.
I really need to get £6,000 for this because it's just too nice.
Low mileage, one owner from you. It's a dream of a car.
Is there any way we can meet halfway or?
We can't ever replace this car. We can't go out and buy another 27,000 mile one owner Herald.
5,995, so I feel like I've got somewhere.
Yeah, everyone's got to have a victory, haven't they?
Yeah, and then I can also drive it away today.
I'm not going to fall out with you for £5. I'm going to shake your hand. I'm going to give you the keys.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy it. You can drive it away today. Yay!
There you go.
Take care, you guys.
We bought the Herald for £2,000. And we managed to sell her for the full £6,000 asking price, minus a fiver. After expenses, that leaves us with £2,500 profit.